The most common dog breeds are the brachycephalics, or short-nosed dogs. Pugs, their whole facial conformation, corneal damage, corneal injuries, the more advanced ulcers, pigment on their corneas. And every breed seems to have their own little special thing. Bulldogs, Sharpeys, German Shepherds, Border Collies, Greyhounds.
It's a lot of responsibility. Are there any specific breeds where if someone's interested in that breed, they might want to know about some genetic types of eye problems ahead of time and make sure the breeder is screening for them?
Yeah, 100%. The most common dog breeds that we're going to see are the brachycephalics. So those with the short noses. They tend to have short noses, large eyes, which is what makes them so appealing to people. But the problem with that is that they often have a reduced corneal sensitivity as well. That's just in their genetics. And as a consequence of that, we do see more advanced ulcers. It's not to say that other dog breeds don't get ulcers. They absolutely do. But I would say the brachycephalics or the short-nosed dogs, we're going to be seeing them probably a little bit more advanced stage. And so they're a little bit harder to manage sometimes. With cats, we're going to be seeing a lot more Persians. Again, that falls into the brachycephalic breed as well. And so again, with them, we're seeing a lot of corneal damage, corneal injuries as well.
We might as well just give a quick fill-in on what the cornea is for people who may not have ever heard that. Basically, the cornea, I always think of it kind of like the windshield of the eye.
It's that's exactly how I describe it to owners. Exactly. So it's the clear window of the eye. It's the front line, I suppose, apart from an eyelid, it's the front line of an injury that's going to happen.
Yeah.
We do see cataracts as well. That's further into the eye. That's in the lens. So that's what should be clear. That's allowing you to see through into the back of your eye. But for genetic reasons or even acquired reasons, we're seeing cataracts that form. And so cataracts for sure. Ask your breeders about whether or not that's something that's in the line that's known about. Sometimes cataracts come up in later life, and those can be really tricky because the breeders, with all good intentions, have gone through all the normal puppy-related screen checks, but the cataracts may not actually be something that develops until a later age. And so those would get mixed until they're older. Other things through anatomy, for example, can be a problem for the patient. So with the brachycephalic breeds that I talked about, pugs would be a good example of that. They'd have a tendency to develop pigment on their corneas, and that's related to overexposure, not only from having a huge cornea, the clear part of the eye, but also having large eyelids that actually don't close all that well over the surface. And so the cornea, when it's chronically irritated, will become pigmented, just like your skin would be when it's chronically irritated. And then every breed seems to have their own little special thing that they can get. So German Shepherds, Border Collies, Greyhounds can have something called pannus, which is an exposure keratitis for the cornea. So it's an inflammation of the cornea, easily treated, pretty easily diagnosed. So that's not a huge drama. But other breeds like Bulldogs or Sharpeys will often have a real problem with their eyelid conformation, in that they tend to have so much eyelid that it rolls in, and that can be a problem. And that's something that's multifactorial. So I wouldn't say it's one identified gene that the breeders would be looking for, but it's their whole facial conformation. That's something that you should be able to get a good idea from the breeder about how the parents of the puppies were, for example.
That's really helpful advice. You would hope that a really responsible breeder would kind of keep tabs on any medical problems that arise within all of the puppies that they've bred throughout.
Yeah, 100%. It's hard work. Breeding is a tough business, boy.
It's a lot of responsibility.